Now at 5, after years of effort, officials breaking ground today on a big project to bring a brand new aquatic center to East Yakima. This comes as temperatures are about to really start feeling like summer. Details of just how hot it's going to get ahead in your First Alert weather forecast. And with summer weather comes fire danger. An Eastern Washington power company's plan to hopefully lower fire risk could mean some serious inconvenience for customers.
This is Apple Valley News Now at 5, on your side.
We have made it to Wednesday. Good evening, everybody. Thanks for being here. I'm Austin Breed. Alyssa Warner is on assignment. And we begin with developing news. SELA firefighters are battling a growing brush fire just off Interstate 82. This is near Heartland Landing. The fire chief tells Apple Valley News Now that the blaze has been spreading quickly and they have help from the Washington Department of Natural Resources, which is on the way. It is not clear yet how this fire started. Well, the Kennewick Irrigation District has a new executive director, and with summer coming up, we're wondering if a mandatory watering schedule will be in effect for residents. Shane Leonard is now leading the charge for KID. He comes to the Tri-Cities from Arizona with decades of experience. Leonard told us today that he knows all too well about drought conditions. A voluntary watering schedule for residents using KID went into effect back in March. Leonard says during low water years, canals carry less water. If everyone waters their lawns in the morning, it creates a surge in demand that can quickly deplete canal levels. This drop in pressure can lead to people watering for longer periods to compensate, further straining the system. As for that mandatory watering schedule, well, here's what Leonard had to say about that.
At this point, unfortunately, I do. We have had snow and rain in the reservoir systems. Unfortunately, what's occurred this year, as has occurred to similar years, is we got snow, but then it got warm pretty quick. But in essence, the water runs off much quicker. It fills the reservoir and then that's it. There's no more water coming into the system.
You will hear more from Leonard and his vision for the future. That's coming up new at 6 tonight and only right here on Apple Valley News Now. Well, we've been talking about those warmer temperatures. Let's check in with meteorologist Hayden Nix. He's in for Stacy this week with a first look at your forecast. Good evening.
Yeah, and you know what? We traded out the wind for warmer weather today, and I'm glad to say that for that little brush fire going on, that we're not really going to see the wind be a tremendous factor. Still a little bit on the lighter breeze side with those barely double-digit readings, but thankfully these are going to continue to lighten up as we head into the remainder of the evening and overnight hours. We were going in the 60s yesterday, now making it to 70 degrees being reported there at Dust Devil Stadium in Pasco with that wind at 10 miles per hour. The flag barely whipping right there on the back end of the video screen there. Temperature wise elsewhere, we're holding in the lower 70s from the Tri-Cities back northwestern towards Hanford, 71 in Prosser, 74 in Yakima. We've got 62 back off towards Walla Walla, where cloud cover was slower to push east today. We're going to go with temperatures in the 40s tonight, which is seasonable, so not too bad there. But tomorrow, going out of the 70s, heading into the lower 80s, but we're not stopping there. We're possibly looking at maybe our first 90-degree day. We're going to talk more about that in just a little bit.
All right, Hayden, thank you for that. Other news, new tonight, Yakima Police Chief Matt Murray announcing he is retiring at the end of June. Murray became chief of the Yakima Police Department back in 2019. Earlier this year, he told Apple Valley News Now that Yakima has overall seen a crime decrease since he took office. He said there has been an increase, though, in drug and domestic violence crimes, but attributed that to better enforcement efforts. The interim city manager says they will start looking soon for an interim police chief, whether that's inside or outside the department.
In-house, you know, people would know that person. There's some advantages to it. However, it kind of shorts staff where we're already short. So we need to consider some of those things, talk to command staff, see what their sense is about things.
Now, he also says they will start looking for a new chief, but won't be making any decisions until they hire a permanent city manager, which will take at least a couple of months. New tonight, American Airlines expanding at Tri-Cities Airport just a few months after their first flight from Pasco. Starting September 5th, American will offer two daily flights to and from Phoenix, Arizona, Flights will leave our airport at 5:25 a.m. and 3 p.m.
Right now, there's a lot of issues going on with crew shortages and aircraft shortages. So normally when they come in with more than one flight, but they came in, they wanted to be here, and I was confident we would get second flight sooner rather than later, and it just had to play out. And
it is going to be a very busy year for the Tri-Cities Airport. Avelo Airlines just added flights to Sonoma Wine Country this month, and Alaska Airlines is adding flights to LA starting in October. When the East Yakima community lost their pool, the city promised to build them a new one. Now, more than 15 years later, they're finally making good on that promise. Community members packed the groundbreaking ceremony for the new aquatic center. It will feature multiple pools, a vortex, water slide, climbing wall, rope swing, a ninja cross-climbing structure, and more. It is a project made possible by the community not giving up and nonprofits, businesses, and government agencies coming together to support it.
Not only because of the inequities that it will address in our community, not only because of the activities for our youth and the elderly up and down our valley that it will provide for our community, but today's project is beautiful because it has brought the community.
Coming up new at 6 tonight, our Emily Goodell will hear from the community about why this project is so much more to them than just a pool. We have a follow-up tonight. Kennewick police say they have now located the 13-year-old considered missing for almost 3 weeks after returning away from home. Police say Dustin Sutphin is safe. It's not clear where or how he was found. Dustin's aunt told us he ran away to avoid going to foster care because he didn't want to be separated from his pet chicken. Again, Kennewick police say Dustin has been located safe and sound. Pasco police credit an alert bystander with saving a child and potentially helping prevent a lot of drugs from getting into the streets. Police say someone called them to report a woman passed out behind the wheel of a car with a toddler in the back seat. When officers got into that car, they found hundreds of fentanyl pills along with meth and cocaine and a gun in the woman's purse. Police say it appears that the drugs were intended to be sold. The woman was booked into the Franklin County Jail. The toddler was checked out by first responders, and tonight they say that child appeared to be in good health. First, Oregon recriminalized drug possession, and now British Columbia, Canada has taken a very similar step. Tonight, CBC is reporting that British Columbia is testing a program that would allow drug possession in personal use amounts. But as of this week, it will be a crime to use illegal drugs in public spaces. The New York Times reports the initial goal of decriminalizing drug possession in British Columbia was to make it so police could focus on drug dealers. But public use quickly became a concern. Hey, it is Wildfire Awareness Month now that we're in May, and while the National Interagency Fire Center is not currently predicting a high risk of significant wildland fires in eastern Washington, one power company is working to lower the risk even more. Avista says it's going to start shutting off the power in certain conditions, like extremely dry and windy weather. Investigators say a tree limb fell on an Avista line during a windstorm back in 2020, sparking the fire that leveled the town of Malden. Avista says they are taking that into consideration as they work to prevent future fires.
We've increased our patrols of all of our lines and all of our vegetation, and so we're looking at in the high fire risk areas, we're getting eyes on that vegetation at least once a year.
If Avista has to turn the power off this summer or fall, they plan to have crews go out and inspect power lines to make sure they're not damaged before they turn the electricity back on. Officials say that process could take anywhere from a few hours to several days. All right, tonight we are tracking developing news. The United States has put a weapons shipment to Israel on hold. Even though Hamas terrorists agreed to a ceasefire proposal, Israel has said it's not enough, and they are pushing forward with attack plans. ABC's Perry Russum reports that it's prompting a response from the Pentagon.
Ceasefire negotiations between Hamas and Israel happening today as Israel moves forward with its attack in Rafah. ABC News learning the U.S. paused the shipment of some 3,500 bombs to Israel, concerned they could be used in Rafah.
As we have assessed the situation, we paused one shipment of high payload munitions.
The Israeli military releasing new video of what they say is their soldiers on the ground in the southern Gazan city. This is what's left after one of the dozens of Israeli strikes. My message to the world, this man says, is please look at what's happening to us. In the last day, 35 people have been killed, more than 100 injured, according to the Hamas-run health ministry. Families now mourn the dead. This woman saying, the wave of my heart is dead. My eldest son is dead. Shame on you. Volunteers at this charity kitchen feeding 30,000 a day say today may be their last day in Rafah, citing a shortage of fuel. On the other side of Rafah's border in Egypt, aid trucks wait to get in. Israel is set to reopen a border crossing today, delivering fuel. It comes as the U.S. sees a rise in anti-Semitism on college campuses. Education Secretary Miguel Cardona says they have 145 open cases of anti-Semitism.
What we can do is investigate cases where anti-Semitism is rampant and withhold dollars if a school refuses to protect students.
Campus protests continue overseas and here in the U.S. George Washington University's encampment was cleared this morning. 33 people were arrested. Perry Russum, ABC News, Washington. ABC's World News Tonight will have continuing coverage of this situation. That's coming up at 5:30 right here on KVU Cap TV. Well, the news at 5 just getting started. Still ahead, we're talking local developments tonight with a popular Kennewick business now expanding across the river. We'll talk about that, plus taking a live look outside in Richland. Meteorologist Hayden Nix, and for Stacy, he'll have a look at when we can expect to get close to the 90s. And it is National Nurses Week. Hear how local educators are working to get more people considering nursing as a career. That's still ahead on Apple Valley News Now, live at 5.
Hello, Shelby.
Hello, Mariano.
Upload Mrs. Robinson's case.
Processing.
Is there any new information?
The insurance offer is too low. Should I ask for more?
You know, when they hear from the heavy hitter, they'll pay much more.
The heavy hitter is one for you. Call 853-2222.
Have you heard about refractive lens exchange? K2 Vision RLE means no glasses, no contacts, and no readers permanently. And you'll never develop a cataract.
No glasses or readers. K2 Vision RLE.
Why is my internet slow?
There's only 16 devices connected.
I'm so over this. My cable internet bill just increased again.
My upload speed is so bad, I can't even run a stream without buffering.
Defeat cable lag. Switch to Ziply Fiber, America's fastest home internet. 25 times faster uploads. $65 less a month than cable. Ziply Fiber. Call 1-888-GO-ZIPLY or visit ziplyfiber.com/goZiply.
The Memorial Day savings start this week during the Sit, Sleep, and Relax sale at Walker's Furniture. And that means savings of up to 70% off. Plus, 5-year special financing is available this week at Walker's Furniture.
Are you waking up in the morning with a sore jaw, headaches, maybe even ringing in your ears, all because you're grinding and clenching your teeth at night? That's exactly what was going on with me. That's when I found this, the Brux Night Guard. Now the Brux Night Guard redirects the bite force away from the back teeth, reducing jaw pain while still protecting the teeth. This unique design is what makes Brux Night Guard different from all other traditional grind guards. Go to bruxnightguard.com and order yours today.
Life can be hard. With Culligan, your water doesn't have to be.
Stop thinking, let things happen, and be the ball. Better yet, see the ball with K2 Vision RLE. K2 Vision RLE. No readers, glasses, contacts, or cataracts.
Hello, Shelby.
Hello, Mariano.
Upload Mrs. Robinson's case.
Processing.
Is there any new information?
The insurance offer is too low. Should I ask for more?
You know, when they hear from the heavy hitter, they'll pay much more.
The heavy hitter is one for you. Call 853-2222.
Hello there. Watch live with Kelly and Mark.
Weekday mornings at 9 on Apple Valley News Now.
Hey, thanks so much for staying with us on your news at 5. Summer's Hub of Kennewick, often nicknamed The Hub, opened just a couple of years ago as we were coming out of the pandemic. But tonight, they are looking to expand. The owner tells us he is preparing to open a second location across the river in Pasco. He is planning a similar setup with food trucks and says there's already a wait list of vendors hoping for a spot.
Second location is going to be located off of Burden Boulevard in the Gisa Stadium parking lot. So right in front of the baseball stadium, right adjacent next to the track. And it's perfect for serving all the people that go to the soccer games, baseball games, softball games, track, and the local community surrounding that area with all the houses and developments going in. It's going to be fantastic for everyone.
Perfect area to do that. He also says the Pasco location won't be exactly the same as the hub in Kennewick. Our Monique Ledesma will talk more about that tonight on Apple Valley News Now at 6 and 6:30.
From Apple Valley News Now, First Alert Weather with Hayden Nix.
Well, let's talk about those winds one last time here, because yesterday was pretty significant. Had some reports come into some significant wind gust here, with Ellensburg taking the title at 58 miles per hour being reported. And that was just before we went on the air yesterday evening. I was reporting that number that had popped up around the 5 o'clock hour there. Yakima at 38, and we had mid to lower 30s from Pendleton down to Walla Walla there at 30 miles per hour being reported. But thankfully, we have switched gears, talking less about the wind and more about a warm-up that's on the way. Take a look at your wind speeds now, in the upper single digits to barely registering in the double digit range. So we'll see that trend continue as we work our way through the rest of this week and heading into a very special weekend. It is Mother's Day, and we are going to be looking at those readings on Sunday itself in the mid to upper 80s area wide. We're talking about a big flip in the script here with our forecast, going from those cool temperatures now to shorts and t-shirts kind of weather here. And it's all thanks to a big ridge of high pressure. Showed you this yesterday, but this is going to be very persistent in our forecast as we move into this upcoming weekend here, with that ridge slowly building into the Pacific Northwest. It's going to lessen our wind. It's going to increase our temperatures, but also give us ample sunshine as well, with very little in the way of cloud cover coming in, with exception of Monday or Tuesday, when this will eventually begin to break down. But we've got several days of this ridge of high pressure influencing our forecast before things settle down and temperatures cool along with it. But this ridge is actually going to bump our temperatures up and flirt with possibility of having some 90 degree days triggered here. So I thought this would be interesting to bring up. Your average first 90 degree day for the Tri-Cities is around May 21st. Now, when we talk about averages, give or take 7 to 10 days from this exact date, if it falls within that range, you're right on average. So I think we're pretty close for Tri-Cities and Hermiston. But when you get to Yakima, Pendleton, and Walla Walla, look at your dates here. We're pushing the end of May and beginning of June. So if they were to hit 90 degrees this weekend, you're a little bit ahead of schedule, but not too bad. But overall, we should be right on par with where we should be. Back to the top of the forecast, though. Tonight, still seasonably comfortable temperatures with those readings in the 40s area-wide, 44 in the Tri-Cities. Back off towards the west, Yakima at 42. We're looking at lower 40s back east towards Walla Walla. Tomorrow, upper 70s and lower 80s, a good mix of both. We'll have mostly sunny to near full sunshine. And then your 7-day forecast shows for the Tri-Cities possibly 90 degrees on Saturday, upper 80s on Sunday. Notice we'll add a little more cloud cover Monday and Tuesday. That'll help keep those temperatures a little more tempered in the lower to mid 80s, back into the 70s by Wednesday. Yakima could also see 90 degrees by Saturday. Walla Walla, it looks like we'll try to hold off on topping out in the upper 80s, but we could be cruising in the mid 80s for both Saturday and Sunday, back into the 70s by Tuesday. For Hermiston, 90 degrees will be possible for you as well to start out the weekend, upper 80s on Sunday, and then back to the mid 70s by Wednesday. Austin.
All right, Hayden, thank you so much. We appreciate that. It is National Nurses Week, and as we have told you many times in the past 4 years, we are seeing a shortage of nurses at every level here in our area. Officials at Columbia Basin College in Pasco tonight tells us their nurse associate's degree program was one of the first that they offered all the way back in the 1950s. The nursing program director tells us they are working to give future registered nurses a strong start.
Once they're accepted into the nursing program, our foundation has scholarships for all of our nursing students that are in the program. And so it really helps with the cost of the program. We have supports in disability support services. We have academic support services, lots of different resources that kind of wrap around the student to help them be successful in the program.
As of right now, they can only accept 50 students into that program, but they are planning to expand. The program director also says many of the graduates stay right here in Central Washington communities. It is Wednesday, and that means we get to introduce you to a local pet looking for a forever home. Meet Ollie, who has some unusual qualifications. That's next year at 5.
Jessica Jalore, Good Morning Northwest, weekday mornings from 5 to 7.
Danny was rear-ended by a semi-truck. Serious injuries.
The back end was in the back seat. There was nothing left of the rear.
Danny was in pain, and the insurance company was giving him the runaround.
Mariano's reputation and experience gave him an advantage over the insurance company that I didn't have. I felt very comforted. I felt like I was going to be taken care of, that I didn't have to worry about it.
The insurance company couldn't run around me, and Daniel got paid a lot.
He lives up to his reputation, which is somebody who gets results.
Call 853-2222.
It's a sit, sleep, and relax sale at Walker's Furniture as they kick off their Memorial Day savings early.
Everything you can sit down on, fall asleep on, or recline back in comfort on sale, with even bigger savings up to 70% off clearance items.
Take advantage of early Memorial Day savings, plus special 5 years financing is available with no money down, making it the perfect time to kick back, relax, and save.
This week at Walker's.
The race continues for over $13,000 in cash and prizes with Wild Horse Resort and Casino's $125,000 Derby Dash for cash and prizes. Play all week to earn entries, then multiply them on Thursdays. Drawings every Friday and Saturday. Pick your lucky horse and ride away with up to $700 cash. Then join us on Saturday, May 25th for the $15,000 grand prize. Three winners will race toward the finish line, and the winner takes home $10,000 cash. Wild Horse Resort and Casino. More winners, more often.
Take advantage of the tax credits you can, including the annual Washington State Working Families Tax Credit. You can get money back on state taxes already paid. Visit workingfamiliescredit.wa.gov.
Why is my internet slow?
There's only 16 devices connected.
I'm so over this. My cable internet bill just increased again.
My upload speed is so bad, I can't even run a stream without buffering.
Defeat cable lag. Switch to Ziply Fiber, America's fastest home internet. 25 times faster uploads. $65 less a month than cable. Ziply Fiber. Call 1-888-GO-ZIPLY or visit ziplyfiber.com/GoZiply.
If you're injured on the job, you need an experienced workers' comp attorney.
Workers' compensation is complex. It has its own laws, doctors, courts, and judges.
For years as an assistant attorney general, I represented labor and industries. Now, I fight for injured workers.
If you were hurt at work, let us go to work to get you benefits.
Call 509-584-4411, Bothwell and Hamill.
So here's another reason to love hump days. It's Wednesday, and that means we get to introduce you to a local rescue pet in need of a forever home. On today's Operation Best Friend, we get to meet Ollie from the Benton Franklin Humane Society.
Hi, my name is Liz Howard, and I am with the Benton Franklin Humane Society, and today I brought Ollie with me. He is a 2.5-year-old German Shepherd, and he came to us one frigid January morning. He was abandoned at the shelter with another animal, tied to our front door. Luckily, our amazing staff was able to swoop in and get him taken care of and ready for adoption. He is already neutered and ready to go home and is just a wonderful dog. He knows basic commands. Ollie, sit. Good job, Ollie. I know, good job. His adoption fee is $55, and like I said, he is already all neutered, ready to go home and make a wonderful pet for someone. Another amazing thing about Ollie is that he does well with a lot of dogs. He is what we call a starter dog in our puppy play groups, so we know that we can trust him with supervision, of course. When we introduce most new dogs, we think that he would do well at a home with other animals. Chippy is a great yard dog and loves getting his energy out that way. He loves to play fetch and he loves to play tug of war, all of the good games that get the dogs wagging their tails. And anyone that adopts Ollie will get a $50 gift card, compliments of Paw's Natural Pet Emporium.
And it sure is going to be a great time to get outside and have fun with your pet when it comes to our weather. And Hayden will have a final look at that right after this.
Hello there. Watch live with Kelly and Mark.
Weekday mornings at 9 on Apple Valley News Now.
Bath Fitter does showers? That's right. We offer a wide selection of beautiful and functional showers in all shapes and sizes. We can even convert your bath into a shower. How about that? With our seamless one-piece walls and hundreds of design options, you'll get a beautiful new shower to fit your needs, guaranteed for life. Bath Fitter's been around for 40 years, and we've been experts in showers for just as long. Get yours today. Bath Fitter, it just fits. Go to bathfitter.com to book your free consultation.
When you need legal help, trust Quantum Legal. In football, your team can have a bad season. In real life, when you are having a bad season, you can call Quantum Legal. We're here for you in times of trouble, whether you need assistance with criminal defense, personal injury, or have been injured on the job. And with tens of millions of dollars collected on behalf of clients, we will find the best solution for your situation. Call us today at 509-783-5551 or visit us online at quantumlegal.com.
Tonight, tracking the deadly tornado outbreak and damage as the severe weather moves east. Plus, the Israel-Hamas war and Rafah. What happens next? More Americans turn to World News Tonight with David Muir, the most watched newscast on television.
Ladies and gentlemen, get ready to experience the clairvoyance. Friday, June 21st, Legends Casino Hotel Toppenish, featuring never-before-seen mental magic and spectacular illusions, with a special appearance by Mr. Coney Hondini, the world's first mind-reading dog. Friday, June 21st, 8 p.m., Legends Casino Hotel Toppenish. Tickets at Ticketmaster and Legends Casino Gift Shop. Experience the clairvoyance live.
At Bruce Heating and Air, your comfort is our business. With over 30 years of professional HVAC experience for residential and commercial properties, you can rest assured your heating and air system is in good hands. In addition to providing quality heating, air conditioning, ventilation, and installation services, Bruce Heating and Air also houses a full-service sheet metal fabrication shop.
Now through June 30th, receive rebates up to $1,950 off on a new Daikin Fit system when you finance through Bruce Heating and Air.
Category. Things you'll hear on Jeopardy! Masters this season.
Who is Aquinas?
What is cuneiform?
What's vulcanization?
What's potty training?
Which terrifying possibility will it be?
Six of the greatest minds to ever take the Jeopardy! Stage compete for $500,000.
You're both slightly competitive humans.
And the title of Jeopardy! Masters champion. You feel like to win Jeopardy! Masters, it's going to have to go through you?
That is how a final boss works, Ken.
Jeopardy! Masters primetime event continues tonight on ABC and stream on Hulu.
The White Card, a powerful resource for former Hanford and DOE employees. If you worked in the area and have come down with cancer, lung disease, Parkinson's, or renal failure, you may be eligible for financial compensation and healthcare services. A simple phone call can get the process started. Atomic Home Health. Don't wait. Call today.
Well, I don't know if it's just me, but today the weather really started changing. Meteorologist Hayden Nix back with our first alert weather forecast. So, Hayden, how is it looking now as we've hit the middle of the week?
Warmer weather, that's all I can say. We are going to continue to see these numbers climbing up even more compared to where we were today and right now. But tonight, we will get back down to seasonably comfortable temperatures and what we should be seeing for this time of the year with those readings in the 40s there. No more 30s, at least for the next 7 days here. Tomorrow, those temperatures will warm generally in the upper 70s to lower 80s area-wide. And then after that, your 7-day forecast shows we will climb even more, heading to 90 degrees being possible as we begin the start of Mother's Day weekend in the Tri-Cities. Yeah, it can be the same flavor there, 90 degrees on Saturday. And then for Mother's Day itself, upper 80s for both locations. We'll add a little cloud cover going into next week, but enjoy plenty of sunshine for the next couple of days here. We'll go with mid-80s for Walla Walla for the weekend, and then upper 80s to near 90 for Harveston as well for those locations. Then, as we head into the mid part of next week, those temperatures will start to cool back down as the ridge that's going to give us this warm weather begins to weaken and moves out of the Pacific Northwest. Austin?
Moms are going to be happy. Hayden, thank you. Well, that's going to do it for us tonight. Thanks for watching. I'm Austin Reed, hoping your news is good news. We'll be back tonight at 6. World News Tonight with David Muir is next.